In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create this custom old film effect, including a transition. Hi, my name is Manuel. We'll start with the actual film frame, then color correct footage, add grain and dust, and finally add a transition, using basic expressions and standard effects only. Stick around and dive right in with me. I already created a comp named footage and added my scenes. So the comp lengths in this tutorial depend on the footage you have. And I created a second one named film frame with a simple black background solid, which we start with now. With no solid selected, we grab the rounded rectangle tool and double click on it to create a rectangle. We open the rectangle path property and uncheck the constraint proportions chain here and set the size to 1800 by 820 pixels. Then we set the roundness to 55. Let's name it film frame. Fill white, no stroke by the way. Next, we right-click on the solid to add the layer style inner shadow. We open the inner shadow property and set the opacity to 100%. Distance 0, choke 15%, size around 100. Let's add a bit of noise, 2%, so it fades out towards the edges. Then we use the film frame layer as the inverted luma mat for the background. Very clean, so head over to the Effects and Presets window and add roughened edges. Edge type cut, border 10, edge sharpness 1, fractional influence 1, scale around 750. Hiding the path for a better view, and complexity 10. The straight lines are messed up a bit. Alright, we duplicate the effect to add more tiny details. Edge type, roughen, scale way down to around 12. Now we need it to move over time, so we click on the evolution stopwatch while holding option to add an expression and type wiggle parenthesis semicolon and then in between the parentheses 2,800, which means 2 times per second the evolution increases by 800 degrees. Then we open the second effects property and link the evolution property to the one we just animated. Awesome. One more layer of details. We duplicate the film frame layer, name it film frame dirt and make it visible. We hide the fill, add a stroke, color a dark blue, stroke width around 30 pixels. Let me solder that layer for now. That's how it actually looks. Let's reduce the opacity to around 35%. Then we delete one of the roughen edges effects and link the evolution of the remaining one to the evolution property with the expression. Here we go. Let's close all that stuff again. And change some of the evolution settings. Border around 65, scale around 750, stretch width or height around 7.3. And we add a Gaussian blur effect and set the blurriness to 5. Alright, film frame, done. Let's set the actual effect up. We create a new comp. Name it film effect and add a simple black solid, named background. Then we add the footage comp and the film frame comp above it. That's the basic setup. Now let's color correct the footage. That very much depends on the footage you have, of course. But here are some basic things I would do. First of all, add hue saturation and reduce the master saturation. Then I would add curves and pull the curve down, a bit down here, to make the dark parts darker, then up here at the top to make the highlights brighter. Then I would add exposure and set the gamma correction to 1.5 to make it look slightly overexposed. To let this value flicker, we click on that stopwatch here while holding option to add an expression. gaussRandom parenthesis semicolon. And in between we add 1.2, 1.8. The expression picks random values between those two numbers, and gauss means values closer to the middle value 1.5 are picked more often, which makes it look more natural. Awesome, much better already. Let's add a vignette. We add a black solid, Shift Command Y, name it vignette, and double click on the ellipse tool up here, which adds a new mask. We set the mode to subtract and add a around 800 pixels mask feather. Then we need some scratches and dust. Add another solid, name it scratches, and add turbulent noise. Fractional noise smeary, contrast around 550. We open Transform and uncheck Uniform Scaling, Scale Width, 6, Scale Height, 600. Then we set the blending mode of the layer to Screen. The less contrast, the more scratches there are. We animate the evolution by adding a wiggle expression. Wiggle, parenthesis, semicolon, and in between 4,200. We duplicate the solid, name it Dust, and change the effect settings, actually just the scale, to 15 each. We duplicate the Dust solid, name it Dust Big, and set the contrast to 600. Change the scale to 50 each for bigger but less particles. Let's reduce the opacity of the dust layers to 75%. Awesome, getting there. Next, we add an adjustment layer, Option Command Y, name it Position. Then we select all layers below except the background and link it to the new layer. We open the Transform property and right-click on Position to separate the dimensions, because we only want to animate the Y position. We add another gaussRandom expression, gaussRandom, parenthesis, semicolon, and this time in between 530,550, which makes the connected layers randomly jump up and down. We add another adjustment layer, name it Grain, and surprise, add Grain. Let's switch to the final output here. Maybe reduce the size to 0.8. We add one last adjustment layer, name it Posterize Time. Of course, we add Posterize Time. And set the frame rate to 12. Awesome! That's the film effect. We didn't use any keyframes, so it should be quite easy to adjust the comp length. One last thing, let's add a transition. We grab the film effect comp and drag it onto the comp symbol down here, name the new comp film effect transition, and open it. Let's see where the cut in the footage is. 49 frames, let's quickly add a marker. Then we duplicate the comp, set the endpoint at 45 frames, the endpoint at 53 frames, like 4 frames before and after the cut. Duplicate it once more and open the two position properties. Move one right below the screen, which is plus 1080 pixels, and one above, which is minus 1080 pixels. Then we link the two comps to the bottom comp. Open the position property of the bottom comp and set a keyframe at 45 and 53 frames. Then we go to 47 frames and choose a random Y position. Another one at 49 frames. And one more at 51 frames. Then we add an adjustment layer, name it Exposure, adjust the start and end point and add Exposure. Set two keyframes for the gamma correction at 45 and 53 frames. And in between at 49 frames, we set it to around 1.85. Let's see. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and ring the bell to get notified when my next video is coming out. Thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Bye!